Welcome to this video playlist about the best methods for converting aliphatic alcohols into alkyl fluorides. In this first part, I'll show you some examples of the use of hydrogen fluoride as deoxyfluorinating reagent. This is the least expensive reagent available, but unfortunately, only highly reactive alcohols can be converted into fluoride with this reagent. More powerful and versatile deoxyfluorinating reagents are presented in parts 2 to 5 of this playlist. So, what can alkyl fluorides be used for? Few examples have been reported of their use as synthetic intermediates, because alkyl fluorides are weak electrophilic alkylating reagents only and often way too expensive because of the difficulties of their preparation. Moreover, some alkyl fluorides are exceedingly toxic, and this toxicity does not necessarily correlate with their reactivity and is difficult to infer from their structure. One group of toxic organofluorine compounds are fluoroacetic acid and any compound that will be metabolized to fluoroacetic acid, for instance, primary linear alkyl fluorides with an even number of carbon atoms. Fluoroacetic acid is metabolized into an inhibitor of the enzyme aconitase, which is critical for the citric acid cycle. There are, however, several other chemically stable but highly toxic organofluorine compounds, and new fluorinated compounds should be treated with great care, in particular if these are volatile. The reaction on this slide shows how unreactive alkyl fluorides are, even benzylic fluorides. Benzyl bromides, for instance, quaternize quinuclidine at 25 degrees Celsius about 2 million times faster than a benzyl fluoride at 100 degrees Celsius. The main use of fluororganic compounds is in the development of new drugs and agrochemicals, one reason being that fluorine is sufficiently small to act as bioisoster of hydrogen. Because the carbon-fluorine bond is very strong and can usually not be cleaved homolytically, replacement of metabolically labeled CH bonds by CF bonds will usually block metabolic hydroxylation at this site and enhance the in vivo half-life of the compound. Trifluoromethyl groups are chemically and metabolically quite stable and are used in medicinal or agrochemistry as inert hydrophobic substituent. Fluororganic compounds are also used as refrigerants, as propellants, and as inhalation anesthetics. The radioactive isotope F18 is a positron emitter with a half-life of 110 minutes and is used as radiotracer in positron emission tomography. The direct deoxyfluorination of alcohols by hydrogen fluoride proceeds by the same mechanism as that of other hydrogen halides. Protonation of the hydroxyl group converts it into a good leaving group that can be substituted by fluoride either by SN2 or by intermediate formation of a carbocation. Typical side reactions are ether formation and elimination. The resulting olefins sometimes add hydrogen fluoride but are usually polymerized. Because fluoride is a very small anion, actually the smallest besides hydride, the electrostatic field on its van der Waals surface is extremely strong. This leads to strong bonds to protons and to solvent molecules, what diminishes the reactivity of fluoride as nucleophile. Eliminations and ether formation are therefore more prevalent in reactions with hydrogen fluoride than with the other hydrogen halides. Because of the short, strong bond between protons and fluoride, hydrogen fluoride is a weak acid, only slightly more acidic than acetic acid. Its high dielectric constant, however, facilitates the formation of carbocations from alcohols or olefins. Hydrogen fluoride has the same dielectric constant as formamide and is therefore a good solvent for ionic compounds. The main advantages of hydrogen fluoride as deoxyfluorinating reagent are its low price and the fact that the only byproduct of the reaction is water. Unfortunately, only few alcohols undergo clean transformation into the corresponding alkyl fluorides by treatment with hydrogen fluoride. Only readily carbocation-forming alcohols, such as allylic, benzylic, or tertiary alcohols, are suitable starting materials, and yields are often low. Although hydrogen fluoride does not cleave peptide bonds, it is very destructive to living tissue and must be handled with great care. The lethal concentration, at which 50% of the test animals die within 1 hour, is only 0.2%. And in many industries, the large-scale use of neat hydrogen fluoride is being phased out due to safety concerns. Moreover, hydrogen fluoride corrodes glass. A further disadvantage of this reagent is its high tendency to cause polymerization reactions, what may be one of the reasons for the low yields of most deoxyfluorination reactions with hydrogen fluoride. Because neat hydrogen fluoride is not easy to handle safely, a number of alternative reagents have been developed. None of them, however, is significantly better suited for transforming alcohols into fluorides. Here are two early attempts to convert butanol into butyl fluoride with HF. At room temperature, no reaction occurred, and the starting alcohol was recovered unchanged. At 100 degrees Celsius and under pressure, however, still no butyl fluoride, but mainly fluorine-free oligomers of butanol were formed, probably ethers and oligomerized butene. With the more reactive cyclobutanol, a 20% yield of cyclobutyl fluoride could be achieved by treatment with an excess of hydrogen fluoride, but mostly ethers and butadiene were obtained. The cyclobutyl cation readily rearranges into cyclopropyl methyl and allyl cations, and some of the byproducts observed resulted from these rearranged cations. Terzbutanol, however, can be converted into terzbutyl fluoride. Nevertheless, the yield attained in this older article was only 55%. Despite the excess of hydrogen fluoride, some of the starting alcohol underwent elimination to isobutylene and probably also oligomerization. Fluorinated steroids were hot in the 60s, both as potential anti-inflammatories and as oral contraceptives. In this example, a steroid-derived allylic alcohol was converted into the corresponding fluoride by treatment with anhydrous hydrogen fluoride. Although a selective deoxyfluorination without allylic rearrangement could be achieved, the yield was low. No elimination of the secondary alcohol occurred. In this instance, the yield was a bit better than in the previous example, but still only 50%. Here, the displacement occurred with retention of configuration because of the intermediate formation of a cyclopropyl methyl cation. The inventors did not explain how the manganese dioxide influenced this reaction and only stated that its use was beneficial. Manganese trifluoride or tetrafluoride were probably not formed because these are strong electrophilic fluorinating reagents that would also fluorinate olefins and ketones. Treatment of this deactivated benzylic alcohol with neat anhydrous hydrogen fluoride at room temperature yielded the expected fluoride in 53% yield. At higher temperatures, however, the displacement of chlorine atoms by fluorine became significant and would have been complete if the reaction had been allowed to proceed for longer. Treatment of trichloromethylbenzene with hydrogen fluoride is the standard procedure for preparing trifluoromethylbenzene. Not all benzylic alcohols can be converted into benzylic fluorides by treatment with hydrogen fluoride. Most will just undergo polymerization by Friedel-Crafts alkylation. So, what are the potential side reactions? As already mentioned, hydrogen fluoride is well suited to cause elimination of hydroxyl groups and to polymerize the resulting olefins. For example, hydrogen fluoride is used in the so-called alkylation unit of some refineries as catalyst for oligomerizing low molecular weight alkenes. Although hydrogen fluoride is only a weak acid, its high dielectric constant promotes ionization and makes it a useful catalyst and solvent for Friedel-Crafts acylations and alkylations. Further potential side reactions are the addition of hydrogen fluoride to double and triple bonds and, as we saw on the previous slide, the displacement of other halides and leaving groups by fluoride. The next video is about the use of dialkyl amino sulfur trifluorides as deoxyfluorinating reagents. These are more versatile and much better suited for converting alcohols into fluorides. So, don't miss it out!